Here we're fully aired up, and then after you note that measurement, you're going to go ahead and drop the air. Then we'll measure that same spot, and in this particular case, the suspension traveled exactly 3 inches. If you've got a suspension stop like this, you can measure that distance. Again, it's 3 inches on this particular truck. If you've got a spring suspension, measure from the stop to the spring to identify what that measurement is. Then go ahead and air back up. We want to be installing with the air up. in both the front and the back. We typically will just measure to a rib. Now with everything in place, it's time to attach the fender to the paddle arm. You'll use the hole in the paddle arm as your drilling guide. To start, we'll only be drilling one hole through the fender on Here's an up-close view of the plug socket on the paddle arm. You'll slide the 5/16 bolt onto the plug and place it inside the paddle arm. Once tightened, the bolt will hold the plug in place. Next, take the 5/16 lock nut and fender washer and tighten from the inside. Now you'll drill on the back side of the fender through the center hole. Insert the bolt and plug and tighten from the inside with the washer and lock nut. Now it's time to remove the spacers that are between the fender and the top of the tires. Here's a good time to point out if you ever need to remove your fender for maintenance. It's as simple as removing a half inch bolt that holds the paddle arm to the swivel. Other fender manufacturers' installation brackets make it very difficult to get the top of the fenders to be nice and level. As you can see in the picture on the left, both fenders have opposing pitches. One pitches towards the frame and one pitches away from the frame. In the picture on the right, showing the rear view, you can see all four fenders have a varying pitch. This is why we've only placed one bolt in the center of each rib. This allows you to tilt the fender until it's exactly level. Once you have your fender level, you can continue drilling the rest of the holes. Insert the remaining two plugs and bolts. And fasten with a fender washer and lock nut.